This is my 1977 Kawasaki KZ750. I got it for $1,000 back in 2019. I took the bus to go buy it. It was my primary means of transportation for a while. The electric start doesn't work. Speedometer went. So I've lost track of how many miles of fun I've had with it. I even took it on an 800-mile camping trip once. Coming to the end of this summer, though, we noticed the head gasket had gone. So, let's see if we can fix it. Thank you.
Are you getting it off?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I think though you have to get. You just don't want to, the chain to fall into the crankshaft. Is that what
exactly?
It is? Okay. Okay. All right.
Well. Yeah, okay.
You're right, the chain doesn't mean anything as long as you don't move the gears.
Yeah, one way or the other I'm going to be counting pins on the top of it up here.
Okay,
now I can pull the head off.
Oh, right. There's this thing back here. Oh. Okay.
Yeah, it's shut up.
There we go.
Well, sorry to have been a little light on the reassembly details, or the head gasket changeover itself, I mean. These bolts here, or these caps, I mean, they're called blind caps in the manual. They're extremely difficult to remove. They're very tight in there. This one here is such a bitch, we had to wind up torching the sides of it to get it to expand enough to let it out, and prying it out with a lever and fulcrum and all. You can see the ding marks all over it because I was trying to knock it loose. This one here was kind of tight, but I just tightened the bolt in this down all the way, and then it kind of cracked loose, and then I was able to pry it free. So yeah, by the time that was done, I was getting pretty tired. So I changed the head gasket over, retorqued these 8 bolts. They're very light torque, so it's not very tight there. And then I dropped one of these down into there. That sucked, but I figured it out. If you ever drop something down in there, a piece of wire with a hook on it like this. Light it up, drop it down in there, look through the frame on the opposite side of the wire snake here, and then you can use a skewer to kind of guide it up. It was no big deal at all after I figured that out. So here we go. Actually, I got the torque wrong on these, so I have to pull them back out. Coming nice and easy now.
Here's the real test, though.
Perfect. Okay. That wasn't so hard.